Bro, do you know how hard it is to control a vocal that soft?
적응이 안 되네, 두 번에.
I'm actually really excited for this episode.
Hey. Hello everyone. 동바이. 네, 두 번째 촬영 날입니다. 네.
Bro, nervous?
한번 해 봐서 좀 괜찮을 줄 알았는데. 여전히 이 적막함은 살짝 좀 네, 아직 많이 낯선 것 같습니다. 우선 첫 화가 공개가 됐어요. 주변의 반응이 좀 재밌었습니다. 일단 한지성이 왜 노래 재탕하냐.
어허.
네, 그랬고요. 본인이 써준 편지가 민망했는지 그 편지에 대한 언급은 하나도 없더라고요. 황현진이 신나서 다음 곡들 막 뭐 했으면 좋겠다, 뭐 했으면 좋겠다 막 고양이는 보라고 해도 안 보더라고요. 혼자 방에서 몰래 봤겠죠. 창빈이 형은 거의 제일 먼저 보던데요. 네. 티저 나왔을 때부터. 아, 아무튼 주변에 응원이 좀 많아서 행복했습니다.
뭐, I ain't even gonna lie. I like the fact that the other kids gave him feedback because I feel like whenever you take a venture, kind of like how Seungmin doing right here doing these song bars, you love to get feedback, especially from people you value, people you respect, more importantly people you respect, just to see where they headed, and not only the people that you know, but the people who you don't know, so that you could get a understanding of how well you're doing or which direction you could take. I really like that. Let's see what he got though.
화는 좀 밤배경에 그런 야외에서 했는데 오늘은 조금 적막한 이런 실내
JYP shop
하고 있습니다. 적막한 공간과 어울리는 오늘의 네, 제가 불러드릴 곡은 라디오헤드의 High and Dry라는 곡입니다.
Okay, I don't think I've heard this song. High and Dry by Radio.
굉장히 오래전부터 옛날이라고 해도 될까요? 아무튼 좀 오래 시간이 좀 지난 밴드의 곡을 되게 즐겨 들었었어요. 근데 이 화는 어떤 곡을 하면 좋을까라는 생각을 솔직히 되게 오래 고민을 했습니다. 딱 떠오른 노래가 네, High and Dry고요. 라디오헤드의 걸 톰 요크 님의 목소리를 굉장히 좋아합니다. 후렴에 okay. 가성으로 반복.
Hey, shout out to him.
곡이 뭐가 있을까 하다가 이렇게 딱 떠오른 것 같고요. 또 시간이 지나면 이 소리가 또 안 나올 수도 있어요. 지금 또 한 번의 나름의 과도기를 거치고 있는 중이라 과성이 다르게 붙는 것 같은데 그런 순간들 그런.
I wonder if that have to do with the recent song that they did with Charlie Puth and everything. He say he got a different falsetto. He had a different like energy when it comes to his singing. So I wonder if that have to do with them changing up their vibe when it comes to their music, because I was looking at an interview by Stray Kids and they were saying that they have been experimenting with some new songs. I wonder if it's allowed him to change things up and do different things with his voice to where he just kind of having fun with that rather than his original or what he used to, you know?
사운드들을 좀 여러분께 들려드리고 좀 남겨놓고 싶어서 이 노래를 고르게 되었고요. 이 노래 저는 그냥 툭 내려놓고 쓸쓸한 듯 하면서도 나름대로의 그런 디테일들이 들어가 있는 되게 조화가 좋은 곡이어서 이렇게 두 번째로 선정을 하게 되었고요.
오케이. I wonder if that's why he in the room too.
거절하고 쓸쓸한 것 같은데 저 스스로한테 하는 얘기라고 해석을 했거든요.
Wait, he say the lyrics are lonesome and it low key remind him of himself, like he talking to himself. What? I hope you're not feeling lonely, bro.
처절하고 쓸쓸한 것 같은데 저 스스로한테 하는 얘기라고 해석을 했거든요. 남들의 기준에 좀 맞춰 가야 되나라는 생각을 하면서도 또 그렇게 무언가의 기준을 맞추다 보면은 제 기준에 어긋나는 것 같고.
Facts, bro. I swear I cannot make this up. If you guys don't know, I got a channel called Vex Vlogs that I've been dropping videos over there. Literally today, I dropped a video talking about how you cannot live for other people. You can't live by other people's standards, just like he said, because then your goals, your dreams, the dream version of you that you have in your head, you'll never fulfill that side of you. and you always live your life unfulfilled. You'll feel empty and you will feel alone because you are abandoning the person on the inside of you who craves for that certain level of success or that certain version of you. You neglecting that version of yourself. So you really do have to go throughout your life, and whenever it's all said and done, be happy with yourself. And the only way that you can do that is by living to your code, you know, being happy with yourself and your decisions. And if you living by other people, like going to school for your parents, or, you know what I'm saying, doing things that's not, you know, beneficial to you, and it's only beneficial to others, I promise you, you're going to be drained. I promise you, you're going to be like so fed up whenever it's all said and done.
바쁘게 계속 좋은 성적을 내면서 성취감을 느꼈는데 어느 순간 이렇게 돌아보니까 사람마다의 그런 자기의 즐거움이 있잖아요. 그런 yeah. 것들과는 오히려 멀어져 있고 뭔가 계속 연구하고 모든 걸 다 계산하고 있는 것 같은 기분이 들 때가 있었던 것 같아요.
Facts.
뭐 노래가 될 수도 있고 친구 관계가 될 수도 있고 바빠지면 바빠질수록 계속 연락도 못 남길 때가 많고 안부도 제가 먼저 못 물어보고 연락이 되게 멀어져 있을 때가 많은데 이게 그냥 저 혼자 이렇게 동떨어진 것처럼 느꼈던 건지 친구들한테 오랜만에 연락을 해도 항상 친구들은 학창시절에 그때의 저로 이렇게 받아주고 얘기를 들어주고 하니까 그게 바쁜 일상 와중에 친구들을 한번 딱 만났을 때 되게 고마운 기분이 많이 들더라고요. 뭐 유행이라던가 뭐 트렌드 저희 멤버들 자체가 유행이 좀 느린 편이긴 한데 그 중에서도 저는 좀 많이 더딘 편이라고 생각을 하거든요. 그래서 뭔가 마음이 때로는 조급해질 때가 있었지만
What do y'all feel like is the best way to stay on top of trends? I've been low-key lately trying to make sure I stay on top of things and improve when it comes to my efficiency so that I can, you know, consume content and stay on top of trends. But what do you... Is it a certain app? Do you like, you know what I'm saying? I feel like Twitter's a good place to keep in the know. It can be a little bit more toxic, but I feel like it's a good place to know what's going on, as well as TikTok. I feel like TikTok has become like the normal like news media outlet. I don't know. I feel like TikTok really changed the, you might be watching this on TikTok, but I feel like TikTok really changed the social media space. But I would love to know what y'all think. And where y'all get y'all's news from, or where y'all stay up to date for things?
그래도 이렇게 누워서 좀 생각을 해보면 뭔가 빠르게 달리는 것보다는 그냥 지금 제가 유지하고 있는 속도대로, 페이스대로 어디로 달려가고 있는지 방향이 좀 더 중요할 것 같다는 생각이 얼마 전부터 많이 드는 것 같아요.
That's good though. I'm glad he feel happy and proud of himself.
그룹명도 스트레이키즈고. 저희 콘텐츠 중에서도 자아 성찰을 하게 되는 그런 콘텐츠 촬영이 되게 많았던 것 같아요. 예를 들면은 앨범 활동 직전에 나오는 인트로 콘텐츠 저희가 직접 만들고 꾸민 무대에 대해서 저희가 직접 얘기를 해야 되죠. 뭐 투키즈룸, 투키즈쇼, 뭐 원키즈룸 이런 걸 통해서 주기적으로 이렇게 좀 저희에 대해서 돌아보는 생각들을 좀 많이 하게 된 것 같은데 이렇게 받는 사랑이 너무 감사하고 사랑받는 거 너무 좋지만 사랑에 또 너무 취해서 기대 있지는 말자라는 생각을 꾸준히 하게 되는 것 같아요. 스케줄 yeah. 끝나고 돌아와서 따뜻한 물에 반신욕을 해주고 개운하게 씻고 나와서 머리 말리고 가습기 틀어놓고 전기장판 켜고 노트북을 하나를 이렇게 장만을 해서 뭐 녹음 장비랑 이렇게 되게 미니멀하게 제 숙소 방에
오!
드디어 세팅을 좀 했어요. 그런 루틴들이 좀 많이 자리를 잡아가지고 조금
Bro, it's so important to have good routines that not only make you feel relaxed and comfortable, but also fulfills your needs and your desires. You know what I'm saying? One thing that I've been really wanting to do is get a laptop, because even though I do enjoy recording videos right here with this huge setup, or I wouldn't even say huge, but it is huge compared to what I came from. But I also want to have a laptop so that I can go to a coffee shop or sit outside and not only record content, but just edit content rather than just sitting at the desk and stuff like that. I feel like it'll allow me to be able to vlog and do other things that I've dreamed of doing in the future. But I'm glad at how far I've came, and I appreciate what I have right now. And I really have been like setting up and working hard behind the scenes so that later on in this year, I can really do exactly what I want to do. And I'm really excited, and I love seeing that we align in that aspect, because you really do have to evaluate yourself consistently. And then once you do that and you start realizing the type of things that you enjoy and who you want to be, that's when you can start putting those systems in place that really will make your life a lot more fulfilling. Bro, this is fire. Like, I don't know how. I feel like me and Stray Kids always find a way to vibe.
좀 더
unintentionally.
소중해지고 5년 끝나고 뭐 이렇게 들어와도 좀 쓸쓸하다기보다는 기대감과 성취감으로 좀 가득 차 있는 것 같아요. 송바이가 공개가 되고 정말 매일 행복한 나날들을 보내고 있습니다. 저의 소소한 일상이 있듯이 여러분의 일상에도 송바이가 한켠에 좀 행복한 매개체로 자리 잡았으면 좋겠고요. 그럼 바로 한번 노래 부르러 가볼까요? Let's go!
Yes, go!
네, 하이엔드라이 들려드리겠습니다.
He got his guitar man there. I need to learn his name if we go keep doing these. Oh my God, it's so clear. Song by Sumin. I like the energy. Come on.
Two jumps in a week, I bet you think that's pretty clever. Don't you, boy? Flying on your motorcycle, watching all the ground beneath you drive.
Yeah.
You kill yourself for recognition, kill yourself to never, ever start.
Bro, after hearing him explain how he relates to this song, it only adds so much more feeling to the song. That's why I love this song by series by Sungmin, because it's not him just getting on here singing covers, but every song so far, which has only been two songs, but every song so far has been so, so meaningful in terms of his life. And I feel like even when it comes to whoever's listening to this, it's also a nice way to understand that not only do he go through his stuff and he has his own problems, but we can all find a way to relate to the things that he's going through. And you know, you might not be able to certainly relate to this right now, but as the series continues, like, this is going to be more and more prevalent in people's lives, because, bro, we all go through our ups and downs. And, you know, sometimes you feel lonely and you feel high and dry, like the name of the song, bro. I like this.
You broke another mirror. You're turning into something you are not. Don't leave me high.
Come on.
Don't leave me try.
Oh my God, his vocals are just beautiful.
Don't leave me high. Don't leave me try.
Good job. I also love the outfit and how it fit the room.
Drying up in conversation, you'll be the one who cannot talk. All your insides fall to pieces, you just sit there wishing you could still make love. They're the ones who'll hate you when you think you've got the world. Oh, so still.
Yeah.
They're the ones who spit at you. You'll be the one screaming out. Don't leave me. Don't leave me try. Don't leave.
Bro, do you know how hard it is to control a vocal that soft and subtle? Nah, this man's different, bro. He crushed the first song. Second song on Song By, he's crushing this, bro. Guitar solo. Yeah, go ahead, get it now.
Oh, it's the best thing that you've ever had. Best thing that you've ever, ever had. It's the best thing that you've ever had. The best thing you've had has gone away. Don't leave me high. Don't leave me dry. Don't leave me high. Don't leave me.
Great job, man. I'm excited to know what's the next song. Another one in the books, y'all. Loving this series. We also got to react to his new song with Han, I believe. Okay, promo. Anyways, y'all let me know, how did y'all feel about this song, this second song? Did you enjoy the first song or the second song more? Honestly, I feel like I enjoyed the first song more, but I think it just had a special place in my heart. Based off of the history that I have with Seungmin, the second song was amazing. I loved how personal this one felt. I felt like this one was more personal to Seungmin in terms of his life right now, whereas the last one was more personal to his life in terms of his overall life, his history. He had a lot of history with that song. And this song just felt so it honestly allowed me to feel seen. But I would like to know y'all's opinion. Did you enjoy this episode? Did you enjoy how vulnerable he was like I did? Let me know in the comment section below. And also feel free to hit the like button because it does help out the channel. Without further ado, I'm out. Peace and love. I hope you have a great day.